Online class. The chapter is amplitude modulations and demodulations. The course title is 3351/352 analog/principles of communication systems. I am Dr. Zishan Kaleem from EC department CUIY Walk campus. So in this lecture we will cover in detail what is phase lock loop and what are the advantages and the purpose of utilizing the phase lock loop communication system. So let's move to the lecture contents. Sorry, lecture details. Okay, phase lock loop. Phase lock loop PLL is used to track the phase and frequency of the carrier component of an incoming signal. Why we need this tracking? This is very important point. As you know that whenever the we do the synchronous demodulation, for example of AM signal, we need a carrier at the receiver side. So that carrier should be of accurate frequency as the transmitted carrier, because we are not independently transmitting the carrier due to suppressed carrier condition. For example, in double sideband suppressed carrier, we usually don't transmit an additional carrier beside the modulated signal. So for that purpose, we need synchronous detection. So to have an accurate detection, we need to track the phase and the frequency of the incoming signal. So based on that frequency and phase, we need to generate the accurate frequency at the receiver side. So for this purpose, we use phase lock loop. And there are several other applications. If, for example, it has a key role in clock recovery systems, that includes timing recovery in digital receivers. PLL plays key role in every modern digital and analog systems. PLL is usually used to stabilize the systems, and they are also used in frequency synthesizers, clock recovery, and a certain number of other applications. So how PLL calculates the frequency difference? You know that it is important to note that here that we need a frequency difference. We need to calculate the frequency difference between the two waves. For example, this is a wave with a frequency F1 and this is a wave with a frequency F2. So how can we track that this frequency is exactly, F1 frequency is exactly similar to the F1-2? Because at this frequency, we will say that our incoming frequency is accurately tracked. So the concept here is we need to measure the phase difference. Phase difference among waves is used to calculate the frequency difference. For example, that is if the phase difference remains constant between two waves after some time interval, that it means they have a same frequency. For example, you can see that at this instant, if you measure the phase difference between these two waves, this is wave one and this is the second wave. So at this instant, we measure the phase difference. For example, there is a phase difference of 30 degrees. For example, we have a phase difference of 30 degrees at this point. So after an interval, after some time interval, for example, after 10 seconds, 5 seconds, or any time, we again measure their phase difference at this point. For example, at this point, we again measure the phase difference. So in this, if we have again the same phase difference, so it means that they are oscillating with the same frequency. For example, if they are not oscillating with same frequency, if this wave has a high frequency and this has a low, then that it means that their phase difference will also change. So by measuring the phase difference, we calculate the exact frequency difference among the two waves. And when the two wave frequencies are matched, we locked the system. So that's why it's called phase lock loop system. So based on other, by using other other important blocks as well, we perform this operation. So we will see these details later in this video as well. Okay, let's discuss here that why we use PLL. So you know that in voltage control oscillator, usually the voltage control oscillator is unstable and it can generate high frequency, but frequency cannot be a stable value. For example, if you have a you need a carrier frequency, if you will generate by using VCO, it can be affected from by a temperature and a noise, so its frequency will vary. So we don't need a variable frequency, but we need a fixed frequency at the receiver side. To overcome this problem, we use a PLL. So there are number of blocks. We will discuss these blocks later on, but here we will discuss two blocks. One is the master and the other is the slave. So master is the reference oscillator. This is usually a crystal oscillator which generates a stable frequency. So it has a stable frequency, but usually a low frequency, which is around 2 megahertz. But if we need a high frequency, we use usually VCO, voltage control oscillator, which is a slave here. But the problem is their instability. So we need to reference with a stable frequency, and we force VCO to allow that reference. So it means that we use this reference oscillator to generate a stable frequency. How we generate, we will discuss in the later videos, in the later coming slides. Okay. So this is the working procedure of PLL, how it works. So you can see that we highlighted it as a 1, 2, 3, and 4 steps. So first of all, we can start with a 1, right? So this is 1 and this is 1. At the reference oscillator, we usually generate low frequency but stable using crystal oscillator. For example, we generate 2 megahertz, right? So from voltage control oscillator, for example, our target is to generate 2 gigahertz, right? In gigahertz is a high frequency, very high frequency. So this is 2 gigahertz, right? So from voltage control oscillator, we generate 2 gigahertz. But after passing through a voltage divider, frequency divider, we reduce the frequency up to a frequency of a reference oscillator. So using this frequency divider, we generate the 2 megahertz frequency here. So we need to select that factor that this frequency should be equal to the frequency generated by the reference oscillator. So in this case, by dividing this by a factor n, we can generate the similar frequency 2 megahertz. But in case there is a not exactly frequency generated from the VCO, for example, it is a 2.1 gigahertz, then by passing through a frequency divider, it will generate the 2.1 megahertz as well. So when passed to the phase detector, it will detect the difference between 2 megahertz and the 2.1 megahertz. So it will go to the step 3 and pass to the amplifier. And at the step 4, there is a filter. Then it will pass through a filter and we will get the voltage signal here. So the voltage signal will adjust the oscillator, and this will continue till we will get the stable frequency. Like we will move from here again and again till the difference between them is zero, like the phase difference is zero. Okay, let's see from the figure. This is one reference input. For example, you have a voltage, these kinds of waves, right? And at this point, right, we have a delayed version, right? For example, the frequency is different, but we can see that their phase at different points are similar, right? So then the phase detector output will generate pulses, right? This way. So the difference between these two, for example, this is the difference. You can see that there is a phase difference between these. So based on this phase difference, the phase detector will generate the output, the difference output based on the difference. So this phase detector output will pass through the filter, and the filter will not allow the high frequency components. So in this way, they have this kinds of wave generated, so low frequency. So this is the low filter output at the 4. So this voltage, for example, is not according to the required voltage at the VCO, then what will do, it will generate another voltage. For example, it needs to generate high voltage, it will go up in this way, right? And you will it will again follow the process and check the phase detection, like it matches with the your original phase. So in this way, this loop continues on, and phase loop log loop works. So it will be locked when the frequency here matches with the reference oscillator frequency. So this is the process. So this is some detailed diagram. What is phase detector, voltage control oscillator, loop filter, and reference oscillator. So So phase detector, as I mentioned, that we have a reference signal input and the VCO, voltage control oscillator signal input, and phase detector gave the output proportional to the phase difference. For example, there is a phase difference between reference and the voltage control oscillator. Voltage control oscillator frequency, then they will give the output according to the difference in the phase between VCO and the reference. So it takes two input signal, produces a signal voltage proportional to the phase difference. If there is a no phase difference, then they will not produce a signal, and then it will produce a signal proportional to the without a phase difference case, right? Variety of phase detector exists, not a topic of interest here. There can be a number of phase detector circuits that can be used inside this block to generate the different waves, right? Okay, the other thing is the voltage control oscillator. It is a simple oscillator. Normally, varector diodes are used to create this voltage control oscillator. Control terminal to which control voltage is applied, and the output frequency here is proportional to the voltage input. For example, you can look at this. At this point, you have a voltage here, this one. So based on this voltage, it will generate this frequency. Similarly, if you have a high voltage, it will generate the high frequency. And for example, this point, more high voltage, more high frequency. Similarly is the case for the other. So it can be, usually the frequency increases by increasing the voltage. Increase can be linear. I have a slight curve. This is a linear, this has a slight curve, right? But main point is that it increases monotonically. This is the main thing here, right? Okay, loop filter. This is the key element in phase lock loop. Often use simple capacitor resistor circuit to network to create the loop filter. It determines the loop stability. It determines the loop stability. It blocks the high frequency components. Reference oscillator, as I mentioned, that there are two oscillators in phase lock loop. The reference oscillator is considered to be the more stable oscillator than the other, because you know that the stability is the main problem. So the reference oscillator, we introduced the reference oscillator in PLL to counter the effect of instability generated by the VCO. So that's why we have a two oscillators in PLL. So usually the question arises, why we need phase lock loop if we have a reference oscillator? For example, this pops up in your mind that we have a reference oscillator which is a stable oscillator, then why we need a VCO like voltage control oscillator? We can directly use the reference oscillator. But the answer is that the reference oscillator produces low frequencies, like for example 2 megahertz. We already seen that. So 2 megahertz, but if we require 2 gigahertz, it can't generate directly 2 gigahertz. So reference oscillator cannot be used directly. So to overcome these limitations, we use the phase lock loop. So reference oscillator only produces a low and stable frequency, but PLL is used to control the voltage control oscillator, which in turn can produce the high frequency. So these are some reasons for adopting the phase lock loop. Thank you very much for listening, and for question answer there will be a separate session, and the exact date and time will be communicated later on. Thank you for listening.